Okay, guys. In this lesson, we will continue our topic modular arithmetic. And today we will do some operations in modular arithmetic. First one is modular addition. Let's begin with a rule. For all A, B, C, D, which are element of Z, and M, which is element of positive Z, if A is equivalent to B, modulo M, and C is equivalent to D, modulo M, then A plus C will be equivalent to B plus D, modulo M. Let's solve one example by using this rule. Here is given 128 plus 241, which is equivalent to x modulo 7. First of all, what should we do? We should find the equivalent number of 128. The equivalent number of 128, how can we find it? Is 2, but how can we find it? We should divide 128 by 7. And we will get the remainder 2, and this 2 will be an equivalent number of 128. And then we should find the equivalent number of 241 modulo 7. So how can we find? We should divide the given number by 7. 241 divisible by 7, if you divide it, we will get 34 with the remainder 3, and this 3 is an equivalent number of 241. And then we should add these two remainders, and we will get 5. 5 is less than our modulus, that's why it will be our equivalent number. And then here we have modular multiplication, and we have another rule here. In modular multiplication, here also, for all four elements of integers and one element of positive integers, if A is equivalent to B modulo M and C is equivalent to D modulo M, then A multiplied by C will be equivalent to B multiplied by D modulo M. So let's solve one example by using this rule. Here is given. Our first example is 45 multiplied by 32, which is equivalent to x modulo 6. First of all, we should find equivalent number of 45. 45 divided by 6. If you divide it, we will get 7 with the remainder 3. And this 3 is our equivalent number modulo 6. And then 32, our second number, we should find equivalent number of 32. While dividing 32 by 6, we can find our remainder 2. And these two remainders are what? The multiplication of these two remainders is an equivalent number of the multiplication of those two numbers, modulo 6. And by multiplying 3 by 2, we will get 6. 6 is divisible by 6, we will get 1, and the remainder will be 0. That's why the equivalent number of the multiplication of 45 and 32 is 0. And let's see another example here. It is mixed operation because here we have plus sign and multiplication sign. 45 plus 12 in braces multiply by 28 plus 7 in braces, which are equivalent to any number we should find it modulo 5. We have two weights. Let's begin with first one. Here we have three steps of solution. First braces, second braces, and third multiplication. Here, by finding an equivalent numbers of each addends, we can find an equivalent number of the sum of two these numbers. It will be 2. And then with the same function we are continuing. Here 28 divided by 5 will be 5 with the remainder 3. 7 divided by 5 will be 1 with the remainder 2. And if we add them, we will get 5. 5 is divisible by 5. That's why our remainder will be 0. And between them, we have multiplication sign. That's why we will multiply these two remainders. 2 multiplied by 0 will be 0. So, the answer, an equivalent sign of this expression will be 0 modulo 5. And then, second way is easier because firstly we add those two addends and then find the remainder, and we find the sum of another two numbers and find the remainder of them, and then we multiply these remainders as we do in our first way, and we find 0. So from here we may get that the equivalent number of this expression is 0 modulo 5.